Hi, this is Max, personal advisor in Croydon Council's Leaving Care team, coming to you from the former Relevant YouTube channel. Today we are continuing our Hunt for a Home video tutorial series, and we're going to be looking at a further two websites, DSS Move and Gumtree, each of which is quite unique and can definitely be a source of decent properties if you know how to use them. So what we're going to do is we're going to go straight into DSS Move first. And as you can see, we're on the home page. This is what it looks like when you arrive. And what we have here is a search box, just like with other websites you're probably familiar with now. We're going to type in Croydon, and we're going to get no results. You're probably wondering why I would be doing that. I just want to make a point really here. So with DSS Move, as you can see, if you type in Croydon and I've hit no other search parameters, we get zero matches. Now with DSS Move, this tends to be the way with Croydon. I don't know why, but you rarely seem to get properties coming up here. So what I'm going to do, if we press home again, we're going to return to the original page, and this time instead of Croydon I'm going to type in London, which is obviously a very, very broad search. But the benefit here is with DSS Move, you're gonna find properties where the landlord accepts housing benefit or universal credit. So without any kind of filters at all and just typing in London, I get 132 properties, which all in all isn't that many. And as you can see here, we've got them all listed with the price per month and the price per week. As you can see, by the postcodes, they are all over the place. And what we're going to do is we're going to try and narrow this search down a little bit. So first of all, we're going to look here on the left hand side at the property search box, and this is the list of filters available to really narrow down our search and try and find what we're after. As you can see, there aren't too many, so we're not going to be able to filter it down all that much. But what I am going to do is talk you through them. So beds, for the purposes of this search, I'm going to do a maximum of one bed. So let's see if we can actually find some one bedroom flats or studios in this property search. As you can see from the properties that have come up, there are definitely some studios. Property type, so it only gives you houses or flats. We're going to go for flats. And price per month, again, the really important one. How much rent are you prepared to spend each month? I think with this, I'm going to go for £700. The local housing allowance rate for Croydon for a one-bed property is about £724 a month. So I try to aim at around the £700 mark with some of these searches if I am looking for a studio or a one bed flat. Okay, we're going to update search. So 132 properties. We're going to see how far it goes down. Okay, so it goes down to 9. So that's really brought the search down, which is what we wanted. And as you can see, we have all the properties here. So we do have at least one studio flat. Oh, we've got another here. We do have some rooms to rent as well. Okay. So once you've done that, you can start looking through your results, and you can change the way your view is if you want by sorting into price highest or price lowest or date added. We're going to go for price lowest first of all. And what that will do is it will change the search around. So at the very top we have the lowest price properties. So the very lowest on this website at the moment is a room in a shared accommodation for £540 per calendar month. Now that in comparison with some other websites is pretty high. Of course you have to remember the benefit here is that DSS Move properties are always going to allow your rent to be paid by housing benefit or universal credit. So that's the trade-off you make really. I'm going to skip all these by though. We're going to look at this studio. So if you like the look of it, we can click on it. And once we've clicked on it, we get another screen up. And this is where we find out a little more information about the property. So if you scroll down, you've got photos here. Usually there'd be more photos and you can see around the property a little bit, but not in this case. You can see a description of the property as well. Naturally, DSS welcome. And it also gives you a contact number here and also up here. But because we've got a contact number here in the description, I would favour that. You can ask for someone by name, which is good. So if you looked at this property and you were quite interested and you wanted to try and arrange a viewing, then you could call the contact we have here, just explain your interest in the place and try and arrange that viewing. And if that all went well, then you could consider your deposit and rent in advance. And in this case, up here it says fees apply. So there would be some letting fees included. Okay. And that's really how DSS Move works. I'll be honest, it's not my favourite website, but the positive here is all the properties will accept Universal Credit or Housing Benefit, which could be a massive plus for you. Okay, we're going to move on now to Gumtree, which is one of the more well-known sites for finding properties. Gumtree, overall, I do like. It can be a little bit messy when you're searching for a property, and I'll show you what I mean by that in a moment. And you do have to have a good idea about what you're searching for from the off. So, at the top here on Gumtree's homepage, we can see that there is a text box for putting in your description for what you're after, and over here on the right hand side you can put a location. We've already got Croydon entered as a location, so I'm going to click on here, and you can play about with lots of different searches here and get used to it. So for example, if I were to type in one bed, then it gives you some options that you could use. So for example, one bedroom in two rent, or one bedroom into share, or of course you can just click on one bedroom flat. Now the search here is, you have to be quite specific with what you're after. Okay, so if I were to do DSS studio, as you can see, you can really narrow down the search immediately. So let's do DSS studio into rent and let's see what it brings up. Okay, so for DSS, remember that's accepting benefits or Universal Credit, in Croydon you get 15 adverts, which to be honest isn't too bad. Now here's the slight problem with Gumtree and its searches. Look here at this second advert. It says sorry, no DSS, sole occupants only. So sometimes with the searches on Gumtree you're not going to get what you're after. And that's why you have to be a little more careful when you're looking through your search results on this website. Okay, so you can once again sort your searches at the top here by low to high to low, nearest first, or most recent. I'm going to just keep it on as it is. Adds most recent properties added. As you can see on each advert, it does tell you when the property was added. So 15 hours ago for this first one up here, 17 hours ago, and we can go all the way down, and as you can see we can go down to 32 days ago, 38 days ago. We can really see exactly when these properties have been added. I do tend to think that your best bet is to look at the properties that have been most recently added, because it's quite likely that some of those older properties would have just gone by now. So perhaps limit it to properties that have been added within the last week. But again, that's not a rule set in stone. Okay. On the left hand side we can see that there are some filters, and we can put in a maximum or a minimum rent. We can also filter it by property type. These are all flats anyway, so we could have filtered it further if it said house or bungalow or what have you. and then number of bedrooms. So with our search result, we can see that 10 of these are studios and 5 of those are a one bedroom flat. But I'm going to leave it as it is. And then seller type, is it an agency putting the advert up, or is it a private landlord who's uploaded this to the website? And then you can specify if you just want to see adverts with pictures. Okay. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to have a little look at this top one here, so we can see what the adverts look like on Gumtree. Okay, so when you click on it, again, quite similar to other websites, you're going to get a description again of the property with its rental cost per month, and you're going to get some images. So here we go, we got a photo of it. It looks fairly newish. I think it described itself as new build. And there's another picture of it as well. So you got a little kitchen area there. I would suspect that, judging by these doors, this would be the front door here, and this door over here might well be the bathroom, which would be separate. And then because it's a studio, this space here is going to be your main living area. So it doesn't look like it's too big a property, but it does look like it's quite well maintained and new. Okay, so we scroll down and there is a description again under it. This isn't the best description. Some properties on Gumtree will have quite a lot of information that's really helpful, but this advert is simply making the point that it's a new studio, accepts benefits and will go quite soon, and it probably will because people are after these types of properties. Here we can see data that it was that is first available, and it was the 8th of June that this first became available. And if you're interested in this property, then over here on the right hand side we can see that it's got contact details, and it's got a phone number which is blocked out at the moment, but if you were to click the reveal button, then it would show you the full number. Or if you're more comfortable emailing, then you can click on email and it will bring up this separate page where you can put in your message, put in your name, your email address and your phone number, and hopefully the agent or the private landlord would get back to you. I've said it in a previous video and I'll say it again, I think it's always best just to ring them up, because it's a lot harder to ignore a phone call. If you send an email, then that can be forgotten or just put to one side. But if you're phoning up, I think it just shows you that little bit more serious. And of course, you can let the agent or the landlord hear you over the phone. And hopefully, if you're sounding quite professional, then that's going to work in your favour. And the agent or the landlord will be more willing to offer you that viewing. Okay, so that's how Gumtree works. Next time on our Hunt for a Home series, we're going to be looking at a few more websites. But until then, I bid you goodbye.